was just on another plane.
Eric Edward, they call me the Cut Doctor. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I was born in Boston. But I've been in Atlanta my whole life, so that's what I represent. I am the owner of Cut Doctor.
Brand new Lamborghini, a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop. Have you ever met a real new rock star? This ain't no guitar, this a clock. My God told me to promise you gon' squeeze me. Better let me go the day you need me. So put me on that, get the bus. And if I ain't enough, go get the chop.
A lot of people, I guess, don't, you know, I guess try to help people. Everybody wanna get money and they be looking for this, that, and the third in return. Shoot, you know, then nobody asked me for no money. You know, they, even though they were my family, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, they didn't ask me for no money. So I felt like I could do the same thing for other people, you know what I'm saying? But long as I see somebody, you know, is really going hard at, or, you know, trying and they willing to do, you know what I'm saying? Do whatever.
When I met Eric, I was still in barber school. And he basically took me up under his wings early. He's just like, man, I see what you're doing. Come check me out. And I want to say January 1st, 2018, I went out to the shop. And I was like, man, I don't know what to do. I'm still in school, but I ain't making no money. He's like, man, you can start today. So ever since then, like, the people out here, the Southern hospitality is real. And the way people treat you out here, it's a different atmosphere when it comes from growing up north and coming down south. Down south, everybody want to see you achieve something. Everybody got a common goal that they want to see you achieve. So I feel like the people are a lot different. And the struggle is different. Out there, you're going to struggle by yourself. Out here, if you got a struggle going on, somebody else going, they going to feel to chime in and try to help you as best as they can.
When I found Sean has got dang like my protege. Like, my boy got dang go crazy with cutting. When I found him, it's like, I went to the school and you could just look around and you could tell who's serious about it. It could be just the smallest things, but you can tell who's serious about it or who really want to do this or who really want to make some money. But, you know, it's funny, this dude here had on his suit and everything, cutting hair in freaking school. So I knew this dude was ready, you know what I'm saying? I was like, okay, bet, you know what I'm saying? Like, I told him, I said, hey, man, out of everybody in there, I can't even say, but I want you to come to my shop, bro.
What has Eric taught you since you've been under his wing that you cherish the most?
Cherish the most? That's a small, I can't say, because everything, like, if it's not from cutting, just life in general, he's been a big brother, so I take a lot of the cutting side, but I also take a lot of the professional side of it too, him being, you know, a business owner, trying to see, find, you know, different tips that I can use and implement into my own life. So yeah, he definitely, if it ain't cutting, it's something else. Like, I appreciate it, man.
Boy. I went up there. I didn't even call before I went up. I just went up there. So when I went up there, they said the master barber, you know, the owner wasn't in at the moment. Dude gave me his phone number and I got on the phone with Eric and he said that was just his other location. He had one over here. And it was kind of more convenient for me because this is closer to where I lived at and I never even knew it existed. And he said he needed more people in here. So I came in, you know. I showed him a few pictures of things I did. Told me set up at a booth. First head came in. Everyone else liked it. Everyone liked it. After that, we discussed, you know, finance and blueprint, things like that. You know, responsible things like that in that nature.
I wasn't moving just for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of barbers got dang quick to say, I was looking online and different little, you know, where they were talking about what they were gonna do for the pandemic. A lot of barbers were like, well, screw the owner, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, the owner is screwed, for real, bro. It's like, hey, cause they worry about themselves, and that's the thing, you know? It's good when you can get a family of barbers that people are actually not just thinking about themselves, they're thinking about the whole group, the brotherhood, the sisterhood, you know what I'm saying? We take care of each other, making sure that, hey, this person eating, that person eating. Like me, I don't do walk-ins at all. Like, I make sure everybody got dang getting them. You feel what I'm saying? Go to that person, you know what I'm saying? I've been working so long, you know, I'm doing these appointments now, and shoot, that's the best thing happened. I can tell you my customers happy to sit in there and wait 3-4 hours to get a haircut. Now you can come in and get your haircut, boom, and get up out of here, you know what I'm saying? And that helps everybody, and that even helps everybody with his time. You know, with all this corona stuff, I feel like everybody should be doing appointments, and if you're not doing appointments, you really got thing killing yourself, because who wants to be at a place all day and not knowing that you're gonna make any money?